Good morning, children. Back to our class. This is Standard 5 English Lesson 1, Textual Verb. Yes, children. In the previous class, we have completed or done with page number 4, that is, read and answer A part, write true or false for these statements, followed by B part, read these sentences and answer the questions with reference to context. And the C part, answer these questions briefly, will be sent soon in the notes, in the form of notes in the school app. So now we start with page number 5. Page number 5, prefixes. Prefixes. Now what are prefixes? Prefixes are nothing but words that we add before any word and we get a new word. Now, for example, Sher Khan was unhappy about the wolves keeping the man cub. Here, the word unhappy has a group of letters un at the beginning added before the word happy. Similarly, the words incapable, imperfect, disrespect, proactive, and antibiotic have the groups of letters in, im, dis, pro, and anti, respectively, added to some other words. Such group of letters that are added in front of some words to form new words are called prefixes. Children, page number 5, section A, add, in, im, un, dis, pro, or anti to these words to make new words. Already, this is being solved during the online class. This is for children who haven't attended the online class. You can refer this and complete the work in the textbook. The first one, dash, sensitive. So we add the prefix in, and we get a new word, insensitive. Second one, dash, polite. We add the prefix im and we get the new word, impolite. Third one, practical. We add the prefix im and we get a new word, impractical. Fourth one, bacterial. We add the prefix anti and we get a new word, antibacterial. Fifth one, septic. We add the word anti and we get a new word, antiseptic. Sixth one, connected. We can use here three prefixes, that is either rev or inter or this. When we add rev, we get a new word, reconnected. The second one, when we use inter, we get interconnected. And when we use the third prefix, this, we get the new word, disconnected. Seventh one, dash, action. We use in to get a new word, inaction. I am in. In action. Eighth one, real. We add un and we get unreal. Ninth one, imaginable. So we add the prefix un and we get the new word, unimaginable. Tenth one, democracy. We add the prefix pro and we get pro democracy. 11th one, loyal. We add this, disloyal. And the 12th one, hygienic. We add un and we get unhygienic. So this is page number 5. We have already done it on online. And this is for children who have not attended the class. You can refer this and complete the work in the textbooks. Now go to page number 6. In page number 6, we have the suffixes. Now, what are suffixes? The words you now like playful, kindness, and careless. The words you read are the groups of letters full, ness, and less at the end. These groups of letters have been added after the word play, kind, and care, respectively, to form new words. Such group of letters that are added at the end of some word to make new word are called suffixes. So in prefix we use before the word, in suffix we use after the word. So page number 6, B1, fill in the blanks with the words formed by adding suitable suffixes to the words in brackets. Mother wolf was a dash creature. In bracket, it is given fear. We add suffix less and we get the new word fearless. Second one, I am dashed to you for all the help. In bracket, it is time. It is thankful. I am thankful to you for all the help. Third one, if you work hard, the possibilities are dashed. In bracket, it is end, it is endless. If you work hard, the possibilities are endless. Fourth one, Kiran always displays dash to take up responsibilities. In bracket, it is willing. So we add the suffixness and it becomes willingness. Kiran always displays willingness to take up responsibilities. Fifth one, Isha's aunt is a dash businesswoman. In bracket, it is success. So we add the suffix full and we get Isha's aunt is a successful businesswoman. And the next one, sixth one, lack of dash may cause diseases. Lack of dash may cause diseases. In bracket, it is fitness. We are fit. We add suffixness and it becomes fitness. So the statement says lack of fitness may cause diseases. So children, page number 6, suffixes you also completed. And during your online class, I just started with the syllables, which I will be completing it now. And for the others, we will do it again on online. But since I'm doing it now, you can refer this and complete the work in the textbook. Page number 6, divide these words into syllables and write the number of syllables in the brackets. You have to divide the words into syllables and write the number of syllables in each bracket. The first one is adventure. The word adventure has 3 syllables, and when you split it, we have to split it like this. Add dash ven dash ture. That is add hyphen ven a d add hyphen v e n hyphen and t u r e adventure. In the similar way, we have to complete the second one. Second one is mirror. The word mirror has 2 syllables. The word mirror has 2 syllables. That is M-I-R, mir, hyphen, and R-O-R, mirror. So it has 2 syllables. M-I-R dash or R-O-R. The third one, faithfully. The word faithfully has 3 syllables. And we have to split it. Faith hyphen full hyphen L bar. Faithfully. So you have 3 syllables in faithful. And the fourth one, grateful. So in this word, we have 2 syllables. And when you split it, it becomes great hyphen full. Grateful. So great hyphen and full. Grateful. And the fifth one, it is well. So this word well has only 1 syllable and we cannot divide it as putted. It will remain the same. That is W E L L. Well, because it has only one syllable. And the last one, decoration. The last word is decoration. The word decoration has four syllables. The word decoration has four syllables. The word decoration has four syllables, and when we split it, it becomes dec o re tion, like d e c hyphen o hyphen r a r hyphen and t i o n. Dec o re tion. So it has four syllables, and this is the way you split it. So children, we will stop here, and whatever extra or additional work, whatever is there in the textbook, we will complete it in the next session, in the next class. So till then, page number 4, page number 5, and page number 6, you have to complete it, write it neatly in your textbook. And not only writing, you have to read it and you have to practice it. Keep reading the lesson, find out new words or difficult words, and you can ask me in the during the class if you have any doubt. But you have to read other references book if you have any other doubt, or you can ask me. So page number 4, textual work is completed. Page number 5, textual work is completed, except the question answers, which I will be sending you shortly. And page number 6 is also completed. So this is all for today's class. Read, revise, and keep in touch, and take care.